Today, I'm going to tell you an interesting story. Now, one day, Ajay and his little sister go out for shopping with their parents at a garment shop, and they are very excited to buy new clothes. Now, here you can see they are all checking out the different clothes. Now, once they have chosen their favorite dresses, they want to give a trial and check if the dresses fit them properly. So, they all go to the trial room and they find there's a long queue. Now, something happens. Ravi sees that his father takes him and makes him stand in a different queue, whereas his little sister and his mother, they stand in a different queue. And what is even more important, that in the line where his sister is standing, and what Ajay found very interesting was the fact that the people standing in the line where his sister was standing were all females, whereas the line in which he was standing with his father had only male people standing. Even he noticed that there were two different trial rooms, one with ladies written on the top and the other with gents written on the top. Now, he was very curious about why it was such. What was the importance of all this? Why were they standing in different lines? Well, human beings and animals are either male or female. So, there are two genders in which human beings and animals are divided. If they are males, they are referred to as masculine gender, and if the nouns refer to females, they are called feminine genders. So, there are two types of genders referring to male and female. So, what happened in the trial room was, depending on the gender, the males were standing in a separate line, whereas the females were standing in a separate line. So, it was on the basis of gender that there were two different trial rooms and two different queues for the different trial rooms. So, the man refers to a male, hence it belongs to the masculine gender, whereas a woman refers to a female and belongs to the feminine gender. In the same way, a boy would refer to a male, and hence boy refers to masculine gender. A girl is a female, and hence a girl refers to the feminine gender. So, you will notice that Ravi is a boy. So, Ravi belongs to the masculine gender. So, Ravi and his father, both of them belong to the masculine gender, whereas his sister and his mother belong to the feminine gender. So, words like father, son, brother are all used to refer to the males, and hence they all belong to the masculine gender. Whereas words like mother, daughter and sister, these are all used to refer to the females, and hence they belong to the feminine gender. King refers to the male, as you can see in the picture. So, king refers to the masculine gender, and here's a queen. So, queen refers to a female, and the queen belongs to the feminine gender. Cock is the male and is hence of the masculine gender, whereas the hen is the female and belongs to the feminine gender. So, as we have learned, not only the human beings but also animals are either male or female. So, the male bird is the cock, whereas the female bird is the hen. Hence, we have cock as masculine and hen as feminine gender. The horse belongs to the masculine gender, because by horse we refer to the male animal, whereas the mare belongs to the feminine gender because it refers to the female, and you can see they are distinctly different in their looks. One has the mane while the other do not have the mane. The lion is the masculine gender. Why? Because lion refers to the male animal once again, whereas lioness is the female and it refers to the feminine gender. So not just in their names, but you will notice that by looks also they are very different. So here we have another list of words with their masculine gender and also words in the feminine gender. So father belongs to the masculine gender, whereas mother belongs to the feminine gender. Similarly, uncle, aunt, brother, sister, cock, hen, man, woman, boy, girl, king, queen, horse, mare, lion, lioness, tiger, tigress. So we have different names for the masculine gender and different names for the feminine gender. So father, uncle, brother, cock, man, boy, king, horse, lion and tiger are all used to refer to the masculine gender. Whereas mother, aunt, sister, hen, woman, girl, queen, mare, lioness and tigress are used to refer to the feminine gender. Identify the gender of the following nouns. And what are the nouns? Prince, daughter, bull, hen. Well, prince is used to refer to the male noun. So it is masculine. Daughter is used to refer to the female. So it is of the feminine gender. Bull is the masculine gender, whereas hen is the feminine gender. As you can see, prince, masculine. Now what will be the feminine noun? Well, it will be princess. Daughter is the feminine noun. So what is the corresponding masculine noun? It is the son. Bull is the masculine noun. What is the female animal called? Cow. So the feminine noun is hen. The masculine noun would be cock. So in this way you can see that we have the masculine nouns and their corresponding feminine nouns. And we not only need to know which gender they belong to, but also what is the opposite gender called by. Fill in with the male word of the underlined word. So I spent a great time with my dash and grandmother. So the underlined word is grandmother. And what do I need to fill up with? I need the masculine term of this underlined word and fill in this blank. So what would be the masculine term of the word grandmother? Well, it will be grandfather. So I spent a great time with my grandfather and grandmother. Today we have learned how we have two different genders to denote a male and a female. The one denoting the male is called the masculine gender and the one denoting the female is called the feminine gender. And we have also learned how we have different words to refer to the masculine gender and the feminine gender. Now there are many more such words which you need to find out. Today we have learned some of them. There are many such words which you will soon learn. Meanwhile, you can also try and learn up all these and see if you can find out even more. Also remember, it is not just important to learn the masculine genders and their feminine genders, but you should also learn to identify from a given noun whether it belongs to the masculine gender or the feminine gender. We will learn about more genders very soon. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. You can also register for free at deltastep.com or download the DeltaStep app to get all learning resources as per ICSE, CBSE, IB, Cambridge or any other curriculum. Over 5,000 amazing lectures across Maths, Science, English and Social Science. Our unique interactive video technology
keeps you engaged, and our iDictionary feature allows you to quickly revise any concept. Master each topic at your own pace with our adaptive practice technology and 1 million plus questions. Get instant answers and detailed solutions. Be exam ready by taking unlimited mock tests, performance analysis along with actionable feedback, personal tutors to resolve your slightest of doubts. That's not all. You can also win amazing prizes like PlayStation, iPad, watches, and many more, along with certificates through our Earn As You Learn program. So at DeltaStep, learning is not just fun and easy, it is rewarding too. So register for free now.